Hi, my name is Lou Mate. I'm 21 and I had the dream of opening the now only queer bookshop in Sweden, here in Malmö.
I am the president of Page 28. I guess that's the term for it. I moved to Malmö 2 years ago, 2 years and like 4 months. And I wanted to do something queer. And so I started doing lesbisk frukost with a cute gang of gays. And then I got the idea of starting a queer bookshop. When I was traveling in France with my mom, the summer 2019. And we were at the queer bookshop in Paris, which is called Les Mots à la Bouche. And it was so nice, it was so lovely. And I had also seen, like a few years before that, seen the movie Pride, where the queer bookshop Gays the Word in London is important. I didn't know of something like that in Sweden. And now I know that there has been Hallongrottan, which was like a feminist bookshop with a lot of queer books as well. But at the time there was nothing like that. So I came home and I talked to these cute gays who I did lesbisk frukost with, and everybody thought it was a great idea, and especially Sigridur, who got very excited. We talked and we thought we should create a ideell förening, an association, a non-profit organization. And I thought, well, this is great, but I need someone to take care of the finances. Because, I mean, I can maybe make a budget, but I don't know how to do like accounting things. So, I reached out to my friend Ebba, who I knew from like the student association in high school.
She wrote to me on Messenger and we hadn't met in a while then. Like, I think we both lived in Linköping a couple of years ago, and then Lou moved down maybe a year before I did, and then I moved down to start studying in Lund. When she wrote to me, I was very excited just to feel included. It was very like an interesting idea, I thought, and I really loved the thought of it. Other than the time constraint, it was quite easy to convince me, I think.
So we started having meetings and discussing like how we should start and everything.
It felt difficult, like I hadn't really heard about anything like this before. When you usually like open a bookstore, I would assume you start a company. In this case, we were like a volunteer-driven organization.
And then in December 2019, we had the official meeting where the association was like created. When we were talking about names, we came up with Page, because I mean, book page, it seemed kind of literary. The name Page 28, it's a reference to the French film Portrait of a Lady on Fire by Céline Sciamma, which is a great film. In the movie, one of them paints the other or sketches the other in her notebook, and the sketch is on page 28. And then years later, when the other woman sees a painting of the first woman, she sees that she has the same notebook, and her finger is kept at the page 28, which holds the picture of those two. Page 28, and it becomes a representation of like where the queer identity or love or expression can exist, even in an environment where it can't exist. And I also think it's kind of neat that you can pronounce a name in Swedish and English and French, and it makes sense. And in, also in Swedish, posh, if you pronounce it like posh, it's like the bomb. And I'm not saying he was named after my haircut, but I mean, well, it might have been because it's the prettiest color ever. I wanted it to be called Lavender Menace, like a little reference to lesbian strife in American feminism. But then we thought having the word menace in it is a bit aggressive. Maybe we should like keep that on the down low. So, but the lavender was still kept within the color. The pop-up bookshop was an idea of how we could open a bookshop without opening up a bookshop, basically, because we thought that it would be nice to have some kind of thing, like something that you could move around and have and at different locations, since we didn't have our own. So Sigrid came up with the idea of building a huge kind of mobile, portable bookshop made from her old closet that she had when she was a kid, which is also kind of funny. She like rebuilt it. I don't know how she did it, honestly. It's like a miracle. Painted it and everything and put it on wheels. The first time it was at Jesus Baden. She had like rolled it, like physically rolled it on the street from Lönngården to Jesusparken. I mean, it's the right part of the town, but it's not close. So, I mean, to this day, I don't know how she survived. It was built during the summer of 2020. The first pop-up was at Panora in September, and then it was at Jesusbaren, then like a few weeks later at Matochladstudion, and then we had it at Inkomst as well. At the Jesusbaden, when people came in and they were like, whoa, what is that? Because it's so big and it's so purple and I don't know, it stirs up a lot of attention, I guess. So it's hard to miss, and we got a lot of like positive response and people were curious about it. And that's also when we started recruiting members.
Beginning, we were starting slowly to like build up some sort of capital, like to be able to actually finance everything. And we had this thought of, yeah, taking it slow and like getting members,
because we want this to be community based. And then it just makes sense that everybody who wants to get involved can become a member and then have actual power in the association in different ways.
We didn't really know how it would be perceived.
We were really worried about that, and nobody was gonna want to be a member like this year.
A lot of people were very, very excited, and we got a lot of members, and everything happened very quickly. And I think for this like last autumn and this spring, we've just like been going on that same, like keeping it up, really, and just been growing and growing and growing.
Like went pretty well, and it's still going pretty well. Right now, I think it's 140, which is kind of crazy, because our goal was to have 150 in June. So probably gonna reach that. Like I said in the beginning, it was just Sigridur, me and Ebba.
After in this fall, us three became like, we were feeling we had too much to do to handle all this. So we brought on a couple more people to the board.
Last autumn in September, October, I saw an ad on Facebook to become a volunteer or page to work in the book it's got, to select books to sell and to staff the mobile bookshop. At the time, I was fantasizing about opening my own queer bookshop, and I was outraged that someone else had come up with this idea. And so I contacted them and said, why are you doing this? This is my idea. I need to be in on this.
It was a friend of mine that I follow on Instagram who just reposted a post from them that said that they were looking for new board members. And that was in October, I think. And I thought it sounded really interesting. I've always been looking for like a queer kind of meeting place here in Malmö. I applied, had an interview with them, and then I got like elected.
In a nice pile.
From the beginning, we thought that books are quite expensive business because they cost a lot to buy and people don't want to pay much for them. We realized that we would need donated books, and also we realized that people wanted to donate books before we even had kind of planned for it.
We just got a donation, and not a small one.
Many books do you think?
I don't know, maybe like 15 or 20, something like that. Wow. You know, carrying books seems like it's my purpose in life. Oh, nice. Oh, we already have that one, but that's so nice. Inspector Kate Martinelli. Hmm? So many books, I have to count them. 35.
Right now you can donate books at RFSL. Sigridur, the fantastic builder of the group, did like a box, a purple box, who is there now where you can put your donated books.
I met up with Lou and we chatted a little bit about what we could do here in our venue together with Page 28. And since then, they kind of had the offer of open up at Mölland and therefore needed a place where some people could donate books whilst they're waiting for their venue. And I said, of course you can do that in our venue. So we now have a beautiful purple book box. The response has been positive and we're really hoping it's gonna go really well.
Maybe we'll reach 300 books until opening. Last fall, I'm not sure, I think it maybe October or something, I saw on Facebook that Mittmöllan had like a free space, and I contacted them to ask about how much it was gonna cost, because I was kind of like obsessed with spaces, so every time I saw something that was empty, I was like, who owns this place? I'm gonna email them. And I met with Kajsa at Mittmöllan. We had a great meeting and just like I talked about our idea and everything, and she loved it.
I was so impressed by how clear her vision is.
She thought that it was very well needed, but also that it was perfect for Mittmöllan.
I just like always looking for interesting people who want to come into this building and want to be part of that positive change. I could really see what she and her like team can bring to Mittmöllan with their uniqueness and their passion.
But the space was a little bit too expensive for us at the time, so nothing happened with that. But then in January she contacted us again and said, I might have something exciting for you. It was like the biggest cliffhanger ever. She had thought about a particular space at Mittmöllan which they hadn't used as a shop. It was more like a seating area.
I always try to look at this space with like new eyes.
Her idea was that, hey, why don't you open up your bookshop here? It could be kind of like a Parisian bookstore with books on the street and like newspapers and everything.
In Paris they have like those like tiny micro bookshops where they have this thing that they just like roll up and roll out their like little book boxes and fill out the streets. So that was kind of my romantic vision in this very square building from the 60s.
Since it's a very small space, it's I think 6 square meters and against a 6 meter long wall, so it's not really much space to step into the shop. It's very affordable for us, even if we don't have a lot of money coming in like regularly.
It was kind of like low risk for them to test their idea, kind of like all stars aligned situation.
When we started, I saw this as something far in the future that we would maybe lay the groundwork for, and then we'll see if it happened and like how far we would get. But I didn't see it happening within a year at all, actually.
We talked about it in the beginning of the year to open a bookshop, and me and Lou, we wanted to open it this summer for World Pride, but our treasurer, she said, no, that cannot be done. We need this much money to actually even manage to do anything. So we put it on hold and said, well, hopefully we can do it next summer. But then we got a great offer from this mall, with Malam, and we saw that it might be realistic anyway. So then we came up with a crowdfunding.
When we knew that we were gonna be able to open at Meet Malam, we started a crowdfunding.
We didn't have the money to actually open a store.
I think it was published in the beginning of March. The goal was basically to collect a lot of money to be able to pay for all the one-time costs that we had.
There's rent to be paid, you need people to staff it, and you need money to buy in all the books that you are gonna sell. A cash register and bookshelves.
All those practical things that you need.
We were actually having a lot of anxiety about that crowdfunding. We were so sure that like the first 3 weeks we were gonna get like 500 max.
I think we reached 20,000 in just a few days.
I was just in shock the whole day and just looking at my phone and getting this like emails from GoFundMe like, this person donated 200 krona, this person donated 1,000.
We were like completely overwhelmed. We have a group chat and the group chat was just spamming. Everybody was like, oh my god, it never stops, people keep donating.
Now it's reached 36,000 and we asked for 60, but now we're having this digital fundraiser event tomorrow to kind of boost it up some more. We are going to do a live stream on YouTube from 4:30 to 10:30.
Hello.
Hey.
What's gonna happen here tonight?
Here we're gonna have the digital fundraiser.
Mm-hmm. Are you ready?
In the podcast studio. Mm-hmm. We're getting ready. Mm-hmm. We will be ready.
How does it feel?
Feels good. A bit nervous, but I think it's gonna be nice.
Coffee.
Varför gör vi det här?
Vi gör det här för att kunna öppna vår bokhandel på Mitt Mullan.
Ja.
Så vi försöker samla in pengar.
Vad ska hända ikväll då?
Ikväll har vi allt möjligt egentligen. Vi har poeter, en massa. Vi har några scenetecknare, ett band.
Det stämmer.
Vi har några DJs. Mm. Och sen nästan viktigast av allt har vi ett lotteri. I seen it in your eyes. I guess it's no surprise. I seen it in your face. You miss those happy days. I felt it in your lips. Your hands, your touch, and your hug and your kiss. I know it's over too. Know what you're about to do. But I am having too much fun. Break up with me tomorrow, I'll be gone. I know it's not the truth I seek in you, but I just wanna dance now with you. You're acting different. I'm getting drunk again. Oh baby, stay a while. You're acting like a child. You won't get over me. My arms, my hands, my legs and knees. I know it's over too. One last time.
Och inte bara för lotteriet, utan för hela grejen, för hela liksom bokhandeln. As I am having too much fun. Break up with me tomorrow, I'll be gone. I know it's not the truth I see in you, but I just wanna dance now with you. Yeah, I am having too much fun. Kom igen, page 28. Jag kan nästan ta den liksom. Så nära är bokhandeln. Up with me tomorrow, I'll be gone. I know it's not the truth I see in you, but I just wanna dance now with you. Do 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 with you. Do 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 do. And we will never make it before tonight. Let's fake it just one last time. Ourselves. Let's put shit on the shelf. Let's put shit on the shelf. Let's put shit on the shelf. 'Cause we both know we are through. So let's end it with a boom. And baby, we so much fun. Broke up the morning after it was done. I know to walk a shame that we were through. And now it's time to dance with someone new. Yeah, now it's time to dance with someone new. Tack till alla som har kollat och donerat. Jag tror vi har alltså över 10 000 kronor har kommit in. Ikväll. Och snart 50 000, jag tror det var 48 800. Så innan ni går och lägger er, donera en sista gång. Så vaknar vi upp till 50 000 imorgon. Eller hur? Ja. Tack så mycket! Hej då!
We got like 11,000 just in one day and we were so ecstatic and there was crying and there was screaming and there was everything involved.
I was thinking that donations would be the way to go and it turned out it was.
The fact that people are as excited as we are is just incredible.
And it's very like lovely to see. It makes me very, very happy.
Everyone wants to have a bookstore in Malmö.
It's something that people have been missing, yes.
This is such a big city and it has all kinds of different people, but you never really see queer representation here in the same way that you might see in Stockholm.
Queer culture has always needed a bookshop where you can go and find other books and other people's stories that you can relate to, where you can find a safe place.
LGBTQ bookstores are kind of key for so many good things in everyone's life.
In many ways, culture is so important. I mean, to find books that talk about a certain part of a certain identity that can help you understand yourself, but also just finding books where there's a character who's non-binary or a character who's lesbian and it's not a big deal. Like, both of those things are so important.
Queer authors and queer love stories and queer other types of stories haven't gotten the spotlight I think it deserves in literature and culture in general. So I think it's important to have an outlet for that, to have a place where that can be celebrated and shown.
The thing that I also thought about when I was in France was that even the normal bookshops, like, they had a LGBTQ section in the bookshop, and I've never seen that in Sweden.
And you know that all these books are for you.
How are you gonna find that type of literature if you don't know what you're looking for?
You don't need to guess. You don't need to walk around Academia Bookhandeln or a bigger bookshop and was like, maybe I can relate to this. You know, all these books are queer. You just have to look at them.
That was also what made me think that we need to do this.
To have that kind of representation, I think, is really important to just create a more loving and open society.
But there are not that many queer spaces in Malmö either.
And a city like Malmö should have many places that can create community and like-minded people can meet.
In a way, it's very stupid to start a business during Corona.
I don't think anyone opening up page 28 thinking, because I am going to be rich.
But we're not a business. I mean, we're a community.
There's no risk if the community is joining you and do it together.
Like, the reason we can exist is because people want to spend their time with us.
And spaces need creative people who do stuff.
I think community is more important than ever, especially when we have spent the last year apart from each other. I also miss everybody that I don't know. Like, I miss the queer people I don't know, but that I always see at these kinds of events. So if we can do something to remind everybody that we're still here, we're still queer, we're gonna get back to seeing each other, and we can hang out by reading the same books and talking about them, or we can have a digital event, or we can plan for the future. Even without the pandemic, there was missing queer spaces that are queer spaces 24/7, that aren't just for a night or for a week.
One member told me when we had our first pop-up book cafe at Ponora, like, that he missed a queer place without alcohol, where you could just come and hang out.
It's not good when the only queer spaces are in those kinds of environments, because, like, a lot of queer people have problems with alcohol, and also a lot of queer people are not 18, and they should also have a community. So, and a lot of queer people have, like, children, and they can't just leave them to go to the bar.
And I think that might have a value as well.
I mean, we need other types of spaces that can be, that can fit more people, I think.
Just by adding another space for queer people, I think is important.
And I hope it inspires LGBT community in Sweden to support people who do stuff, because I think that is what's needed. If you're having a community around you that supports you in your dreams and what you want to say, then we are a richer country. We're a richer LGBTQ country.
I have always been very enthralled, I guess, by the idea of people being involved in things, like seeing the excitement within other people to be, yeah, being a part of something bigger and seeing other people collaborate to make something together.
This came from my idea and my experience, but it has grown, and now it's involved so many more people who could have been, I mean, it just as well could have been them who started it.
You have to have the right combination of, like, people who want to do it, that they have time, and that they have, like, yeah, the right contact and the right, like, the mindset to actually, like, make something of it.
The fact that we're all so in love with this idea is super important, because we're all really willing to put the time in.
I think you have to have the right ingredients for something like this to happen, and we happen to have them.
It's a board filled with very efficient people that are very ambitious, and they do what they say they're going to do, and things happen really fast.
If for some reason you might not have the time some week or something like that, you can just write and you'll get the support you need in seconds.
And we have board meetings every week for 2 hours.
So it's a lot of work, and some days you just sit there and you're like, oh my god, can I just take one day to, like, not think about this?
But you get to know each other as board members and eventually friends.
Even though it's a lot of work, I wouldn't, like, give it up at all, because it's so much fun, and we're such a close, like, board. Every meeting is like, we spend at least half an hour of it just laughing about different things.
So the meetings become less of a must do to something that's quite fun.
We've still become quite good friends, I would say, just through Zoom meetings.
It's been so weird because we've met, like, every week over Zoom since October. I didn't think about it at first. I was just like, yeah, like, these are my new friends. Like, I, you know, we have so much fun together. But then I was like, oh my god, I've never met even one of them. And then I met Liu for the first time, like, a week ago, and her first, like, words to me was like, oh my god, I haven't heard you laugh because you're always muted. Like, she's almost never muted because she's our president, so she, like, talks throughout the meetings a lot, but I'm muted. So she's like, I've seen you laugh, but I've never heard you laugh. This is the first time. And I was like, oh my god.
We actually had a picnic last night, and we all met together for the first time because J-Lo or Josephine Liu was leaving the board. So we had a little goodbye picnic for her. And that was fun to see each other all in person for the first time.
It's so weird, but it's also kind of cool that you can create relationships like this even over like Zoom.
How does it feel to be so close to the dream?
It's stressful, but also very exciting and very fun.
The goal is that we open up a physical place in like August 2022, which has been like almost 1.5 years. So we're a little ahead of schedule.
It's a bit overwhelming at times. I mean, we have so much to do right now, so you don't really get the chance to sit and just think about it.
Right now, it's more about a more stressed feeling. Like, yeah, we need to get this and this and this done, and how will it work out with all these new people, and how do we make them feel welcome and everything. So currently I'm a bit more stressed than I am happy, but I think that will turn over as well soon.
It feels surreal that we're going to be open. I mean,
sometimes during the meetings when we have like a quiet second, it's not quiet often during our meetings, so it's someone talking, but sometimes we get a quiet second and then there's always someone who's just like, it's going to open in like a month, and everybody's like, yeah, we know.
And I'm excited and I'm a bit scared, but I think it's going to be fun. I mean, what's the worst thing that can happen? Like nothing, really.
We're also just working with everything, trying to get the whole bookstore to actually be able to happen.
We're like everywhere doing things at the same time right now.
Then we have some color samples for the wall.
Mm-hmm. Where then are you leaning towards?
Purple. But the big question, which purple?
We're gonna paint the wall.
Jag tänkte att vi skulle se att vi springer och puttar den framför oss och det är så här. Vi kommer ut ur garderoben genom att dra den.
Thank you. how do you envision the bookstore evolving through the years?
Firstly, I want it to be bigger, of course. I want it to be like a whole big own space that you can, with like a door. That's the dream, to have a door.
We all have our ideas for this bookstore.
It's such a small space and it's kind of like a first step to learning how to run a big shop.
I think it's great for us to start with, since it's like a place where people will walk through even though they don't know about us yet, so they can walk through and just see us, which wouldn't have been as easy if we had our own place.
My vision is that we can in the future have like a big place, a big locale.
I hope we'll get our own four walls.
A big like room or a big store.
A bigger space where we can have events and where there's room to really have this kind of meeting space.
Where people can sit and talk and maybe have some coffee.
A very like safe place, I guess, as well. And just come there and hang out. You don't have to think too much about anything else.
Maybe have bigger events and different kinds of art forms, not just literature and film and music and theater.
Have people come in and play music or read poems or whatever they would like to do.
I also want a tight-knit like volunteer group that people feel very connected to us and that they really want to come there and they have friends there.
And to have also like more closed things, like maybe on Tuesday nights trans people who are parents have like some kind of group where they talk to each other about their experiences. Like it could be very small and niche and still be so valuable.
To kind of get this more old school way of socializing and all that. And bringing it to Malmö with the queer aspects of it.
For queer people in Malmö and also people who are coming to Malmö, because when I travel, I always like Google queer places in blah, 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 blah. And I want people to do that and find Page. Like, I want them to come there and be like, oh, what a cool space, and find a book that they are interested in.
I really envision us being, not perhaps at the center, but like coordinating a lot of different cultural things and bringing people together from a lot of different parts of Sweden and parts of Malmö, just trying to bring together many parts of queer culture.
Space where both like the bigger extravagant things can take space and also smaller, more intimate or like community building things. And also the challenge is to not stop evolving.
We can't get too comfortable when we open at Mittmöllan. We have to like keep this vision going, because otherwise we'll just stay there.
To continue to strive for that bigger space and that can have a stage and can have everything that we want.
We all want to be bigger than that.